Alright guys, so this is a build that we've been working on for a few days now. I'm just going to slowly pan on the camera in a way that makes you feel really sick. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at the way it comes in from the edges too fast. And oh, shut up. Okay, so here it is. This is one of these cities in the map. I built this pretty much all using World Edit, because otherwise it would have taken a lot longer than a few days.
This is living proof that you can build amazing things with World Edit.
Well, I don't know. It looks like lots of penises kind of sticking in. No, it's all right. It's okay. I'm not amazingly
it's all right.
Happy
well,
with this.
Well, from over there, it looks a bit shit. From where I'm standing, it looks really good.
Okay, I'll come over there in a second. That's what she said. All right, so basically we've got this wall going around, and this is kind of the same style as the northern wall, except a bit less spiky. And this is supposed to be just like a massive stronghold, I guess. I haven't really thought about the entrance yet. Obviously, this is still work in progress. It's not finished. But there's not going to be all of the houses done and stuff like that, like I've done in previous cities, because this is all going to be player built. And a lot of the stuff is going to be player built, like lots of bridges and the infrastructure and all that. It's all going to be built by players or built while players are using it, so that it's best adapted for the server. So this is quite consciously a server build, not a complete build, but that's okay, because finishing off all this would take months if you wanted to make it look really good, and it's just it wouldn't be dynamic. It would just be, you know, you'd resort to going, oh, let's just put this house over there, or let's just copy this entire section over there.
Plus, when people join a server, even if it's not a building server, people still like to build.
They still want to build. Everyone likes to build.
And if this was, if they come onto the server, this whole place was fully finished, then
be like, oh, that's a nice city. Gonna go over here now and go play on this episode. Good lecture.
But if the city's kind of not done and a bit gritty, then the players can feel involved in making it.
And also the way there's trees everywhere means they can chop down the tree to build the thing. I'm a bit worried that people are going to start mining into the walls to get cobblestone and stone brick. I'll be fine. Anyway, so this city's pretty much revolved around water, as you can see by this fuck-off big estuary here, which leads into this lock gate. So, you can see we've got the doors to the lock here, so these chains get pulled to close the door. So you sail your ship in here.
Do you want me to enact it? I'll enact it.
Okay, you're the ship, right. So this is a great galleon of the sea. Over the
mighty arr! Arr!
It's not a pirate.
I'm a pirate.
So he goes in there, and then the people in the gatehouses pull on these chains. These massive gates close, sealing off the city from the outside. And then we have this lock. So what happens now is, if you're not familiar with real life locks, down here there's a gate. There isn't a gate, but there is a gate. Just picture a gate. And that opens, and it lets out all of the water, which is of course a lot higher on this side, so that this water level goes down. Obviously, those gates are blocking any more water getting in. Till it's the same level at both sides. Then, some people come along here and push really hard on this, opening the lock gate, and the boat can just sail nicely through and bang their sail on this bridge here. But we're going to assume it's a small ship, because a big ship really wouldn't want to come through here, because there's not much space.
I went through the lock.
Yes, well done.
Yes.
So the point about the whole kind of water thing is that somehow, we haven't quite worked out yet, but this thing gets water from down there to up here. We don't know whether it's going to be some kind of magical lift.
It's a natural spring.
It's a natural spring, yeah, in the middle of this building.
Fabulous.
Anyway, the water comes out along these viaducts where it goes to these rivers, and obviously they spread out on either side, and then it flows all the way down. So it basically keeps the whole city hydrated, gives people fresh water, and maybe they can piss and crap in it, and yeah.
Oh, look.
That'd be beautiful, wouldn't it? So the outer ring is for the kind of stop it. Upper class housing, and
there we go. Oh, okay, I'm done.
That's pretty much all the housing. So, you know, you can piss and crap in that water, and it'll just flow.
Oh, just be out. I've pissed in my boat. I'm still sitting in my boat.
You're so distracting. Then there's the lower level, which is going to be for trade and kind of lower class housing, and also there's going to be docks sticking out of here where people can moor their boat up.
Well,
then we have this central building here, which is pretty much going to be the throne room, the kind of the piece de la resistance.
The Taj Mahal of the city.
Yes, it's where the king lives. And there's a few ways into it. You can come in here and you can see this kind of caverny type thing. Stop it. And there's going to be a spiral staircase going up the side. Then there's going to be floors in here. Floors. Then they'll kind of live up here in this kind of domed area. Another floor here. And right at the top, we have this dome place, which currently has no way of getting into, but yeah, it looks quite nice. Let me just come out of here. There we go. So that's pretty much all there is to show you about the city. But I think it's coming along really nicely. There's not actually a huge amount more to do before it's considered done for the server. But I, of course, will show you everything in an updated way. I don't think there's anything I could do tutorial on all this, because I've already done the tutorial on the walls, and that central building was, I don't know how I built that. Do you know how we built that?
The outer wall?
No, the building in the middle.
Wasn't here when you built that.
No, I think I was in a trance. It was about 3
o'clock
in the morning.
Hey, James, the best building is something that you can't build twice.
Yes, the best building is something people can't build twice, but that's
hence,
not what you make a channel
you can't
about.
Can't do a tutorial on a really good building.
It's not really good though, is it? It's...
You couldn't build that a second time.
Hell no. It's because it's too fucking complicated. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to leave a rating if you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to do other stuff that I tell you to do normally in the end of videos. And I will see you guys next time.